Hello, I'm Michael Woodside. Welcome to Thursday's edition of Social Drawing, Drawing with Woodsy. Today we'll be drawing Vanellope von Schweetz from Wreck-It Ralph. So that'll be fun. Yesterday's grumpies were awesome. Thank you for sharing those drawings because you made me feel good. I felt like he was a really difficult character, but everyone followed along perfectly. So that's cool. We're gonna have fun with Vanellope today. If you haven't done this before, you might be wondering, who is this for? Is it for artists or kids? It's for everybody. So we have people who are professional artists who draw to kind of like ease their mind in this strange time. And we have kids who are learning how to draw. A lot of people who are using it for their homeschooling art program. So we're just having fun drawing together. So we're all learning, and because we're learning, it's okay if you do a bad drawing. It might be weird when you're done with it if you followed all the rules and it just doesn't make any sense. But these videos are recorded and you can go back and watch them again to kind of hone your skills. So I've seen a couple of people post their second or third version of the drawing. So that's fine too. Don't be mad at yourself. I think there's this temptation to throw away the drawing halfway through and think, I'm garbage. This drawing is garbage and I'm garbage. It's not true. The drawing is in progress. You're in progress. We're all in progress. So let's finish the drawing, get to the end of it, and then maybe at the end of it, you can look back and say, oh, I think the head's too big. I'm going to do another one where the head's smaller and kind of make those adjustments as you see them. Since we're in this strange time, we're going to clean up before we draw because our art supplies are kind of gross. They're just pencils and people put them in their mouths and hands are gross. So we're going to clean up. I use the sanitizer, but you can do water and soap. We're just gonna make sure that we have a clean start before we begin. I think that's it, Vanellope. Wreck-It Ralph was my first film at Disney. Today I'm wearing my wrap party bracelet that is from, what is it? From October 13th, 2012. So these are the races we got to get into the wrap party. And the wrap party is like, the movie's done, everyone's seeing it for the first time, everyone gets all dressed up, and there's food and dancing afterwards, so it's a blast. And that was my first rep party. Yeah, so I'll be wearing this for the drawing today, and let's go to the drawing board. Focus on the drawing. Okay. Cool. And then we'll be listening to music from all Disney films, but I'm gonna start with some Wreck-It Ralph specific music. So I didn't get to work much on Wreck-It Ralph 2, but I love this song. So let's see, I wanted to start off with our supplies. I'm using this as my underdrawing pencil, as long as we can see it. I have a backup in case you can't. And then I switched up my darker line pencil to this one, but basically the principle is one pencil for doing your light underdrawing and then another pencil for doing your darker one. If you want to use the same pencil, that's fine too. But I like doing it separate so that you can see how the drawing evolves and changes. So first things first, what I like to do is I draw circles up in the top corner of the drawing to kind of warm up my arm. I mentioned it before, but one of the nice things about doing this is that sometimes it's really hard to do a drawing because you don't want it to be bad and you don't want to like this blank page syndrome. You don't want to do something gross. So by doing all these circles, your page is already kind of technically ruined and that you've already done something on it. So it kind of takes the pressure off the drawing to be perfect because it won't be, mine won't be either. So while I do these circles, you see that I'm moving my whole arm and not just my hand. Whole arm gives me a better rotation. I've had some people ask me, including my mom, if it's better to do circles going this way or this way. It's really whichever way feels natural to you. This is just apparently the way I've always done it. I think it goes into my principle of pushing away from my body. So I start the circle up here usually and then push forward and away and then come back. So I think that's where that comes from. Can we see these? These are kind of light. So I'm gonna switch to this weird pencil. It's two-sided, so that way I only have to sharpen it once. And you can see it definitely doesn't have an eraser. So let's see if this is better. Be a little, yeah, that's better. Okay, we're gonna do Vanellope with this purple, it's called Process Red. Definitely pink. Okay, so I'm just warming up here. And as I do these drawings, I know that later on I'm going to come in with my darker pencil and sort of shade it in like that. So once we decide what our final line should be, all of these scratchy underdrawings will go away. And then we can just focus on the lines we want to see. So you can kind of be as scratchy as you want with your underdrawing pencil and then come in darker with this one. So for those of you who have art supplies or art enthusiasts, this is a 5B pencil. There are all sorts of different naming conventions for pencils. That's a 5B, and the higher the number of a B, the kind of darker, thicker the lead is. This is a 2B, and so it's a thinner pencil. And then there's another series pencils called H. Just show you real quick. H pencils are when they start getting really thin and light. So these are nice. If you didn't have a color pencil to do your underdrawing, you can do them with this. And this is a really light pencil that you can go over with. And they go, I have a pencil, I think it's in here. Well, this is a 3H. I think I have a 6H in there somewhere, but it just gets lighter and lighter and lighter and thinner. So if you're looking at box pencil sets, and they have these H's and B's here, that's what that means. Let's go back to the 5B. That's what we're gonna use. Okay, so like I said, Vanellope, we're just gonna draw her head. But she has this ponytail that we're gonna pull off to the side, so we wanna make sure we have room for that. So I'm gonna put her head circle right here, kind of in the middle of my page, and on my page, it's probably the size of a grapefruit. While I draw this grapefruit, I'll tell you a story that nobody cares about, but I used to hate grapefruits growing up, but I was helping a friend move and it was like 1,000 degrees outside and he said, yeah, when you get there, I have a grapefruit tree in the backyard, feel free to have any. And then I just ate it like an animal in the sink. And ever since then, it's like so refreshing. It's probably like 100 degrees outside and then having this amazing grapefruit was so perfect. So now I love a good grapefruit. Okay, that's her circle. I'll make sure we can see it. Cool. So the circle is the cranium, and I did this sphere to show kind of why we put those center lines on the circle to tell which way the character's looking. So since we're gonna be drawing Vanellope straight on, it's gonna look like that. Her horizontal line is a little lower than that, but just so you know where we're coming from, if she were looking a different direction, it would be turned here. So this lets you think that the character's looking up or down. So let's go ahead and do that. When I do the center line, I do a full arm movement, so it's not just quiet. I've seen some people's drawings on their pads, and sometimes like the final drawing is like this big, and it's really hard to get detail or be accurate when it's this small. So the bigger you can draw, the better as you're learning. And then once you do a couple big ones, you can go into do smaller ones. So this vertical line, let's go ahead and do this vertical line. So we're gonna go just right in the middle. Okay, and then the horizontal line is gonna be, if this is halfway, it's gonna be about a quarter of the way down. So halfway between halfway. Same thing, full long lines. So I like starting with her little button nose first. She has a nose that's like a circle that got squished. So it ends up being like that. So we're gonna put that actually right below the middle line. Take a look at how big mine is here so that you can try to match it on yours. Okay. So Vanellope has this great specific mouth shape that is consistent for her. She very rarely, if this is a smile, she very rarely has a smile that looks like that. It's usually has like a big bump here in the middle because she has these great teeth that kind of stick out a little bit. So this little curve here is really specific to Vanellope. We want to make sure we get that. So let's go ahead and put the mouth corners in. They're going to be
probably about a little farther than halfway between the center line and the end of the circle. Up here, just underneath the horizontal line. Let's do the same thing on the other side. So to kind of get this shape, see how it's sort of like a W if we just look at this part? It's like a W without any corners in it. So let's go ahead and do that. To do that, I'm gonna actually start in the middle of the W. It's a weird place to start, but if this is the center line, I wanna make sure that I get it curved up. So just gonna start right here, really slightly curved, and then I'll just connect it over to these mouth corners that we put in. Cool, so let's give her the bottom of the mouth. So the bottom of the mouth is down here. It's kind of like a U shape that goes from here up to here. And when I do the bottom part of the mouth, I try not to go all the way to the corner. I kind of like start here and then end here. So that way it's not all the way out like that. It kind of gives her a little pucker that happens here in the corner. So just do that here. To her teeth, she's got little, tiny little buck teeth. So we're gonna go start them from the corner here and then stop before we get to the middle and then do a little drop down. Her teeth stick out a little farther. Her two front teeth are a little bigger than the other ones. And then we can bring the corner back up. I'll turn this so you can see the shape. Now let's go ahead and do the tongue. You've seen this shape before. It's consistent, the little M, rounded M shape with a flapping bird. And then we're gonna give her bottom lip. So the bottom lip is the same line is here, it's just a little lower, and it doesn't go all the way up, it just starts down here at the bottom. So once we have all this in place, I think we should do the cheeks. The cheeks kind of stick out a little from the circle, and then come back in and connect right at where the bottom lip is. So that's why I wanted to get this in there first, so that we could figure it out. So let's start over here. So they start above the center line, and kind of pull out away from the circle and then come right back in. And then we want to do the same thing on the other side. So to kind of mark that, I just slowly, really lightly, you can't even see it, but go to the other side so I know I'm starting in the same place. And while I'm drawing over here, I'm looking back over here to make sure that I'm not going too far out so that the cheeks feel similar. So these short strokes are so I can draw and then look and then come back and draw. Just because we have a camera pointing at my eyeballs, but that's what they're doing. I started pretty late into the production on Wreck-It Ralph. I was one of the last people that got hired on. And I was working in the crowds animation department. So I was animating all the background characters. Well, me and a team of people were animating all the background characters, all the candy characters that were cheering, and all of the game characters walking around Game Central Station. Got to animate Bowser, which was crazy. Played Mario all the time as a kid, and I animated Bowser on the tram. Cool. So let's go ahead and just mark in where the eyes are. So the eyes, she's gonna have a little bit of a squint. Vanellope, if this is her eye, which is a circle, she often has this, the bottom, her cheek comes up to the bottom of her eye and kind of covers it. So We're gonna do that here. We're gonna use this line that we created because it's all a cheek, right? It's all kind of related. I kind of want to just use that to indicate. So they're not connected here. They're just kind of, you can see that it flows into the next. So the same thing over here. So while we're in this area, let's go ahead and do the ears. The ears are like, imagine that we have this shape here, that's a C, the letter C, and then you just take this part of the letter C and pull it up a little bit there so that it ends up being more like, well, that's very confusing, like, see how that's very slightly different? The other C was this color. Starts it in like that, but it just pulls up. And that happens about here, above where we did the cheek line. She has these great big ears. And it comes back around here. And you can imagine the C kind of like would close off back here, but we don't need to draw that because the cheek is in front of it. And you all are experts on overlap right now. So let's do the other ear on this side. I'm just gonna lightly put a little line right there to show that there's a little bit of a fold on her ear. She's happy. It's almost the weekend. Okay, so let's go ahead and put these eyes in. The eyes are kind of interesting shapes. They come up pretty straight from the middle and then arc out into what would be a circle over here with the outline of a circle. So I'm going to do one eye real quick and just let's talk about that shape. So it goes up kind of straight and then comes over and arcs back in. Just darken that in so you can see it. Shuffle on a playlist. This is not from Wreck-It Ralph. Okay, so this shape, you see how it comes up from the cheek line, kind of in the almost parallel to the middle here, and then it starts pulling away towards the other side of the eye. So let's, while we're warmed up with that shape, let's go ahead and do it on the other side. Whenever I draw Vanellope, I always have a hard time making the eyes the same size. It's pretty close. So she also has these cute eyelashes out here on the side. So from the bottom, I'm just going to start drawing these little rounded Vs. They're like pretty distinct eyelashes and they get bigger as they go up and then they connect to the top. Let's do the same on the other side. Eventually when we have our darker color, we're gonna color those in. So I did four of them, but you can do three, whatever you have room for on your page. And what's fun about Vanellope too is that she's got an attitude. So her eyebrows, I'm not gonna draw them bright, happy eyebrows. Her eyebrows are usually a little furrowed. And by furrowed, it means like when you're, you know, when you get angry, your brow comes together like this. It comes down and then it's like the skin, the meat that sort of accumulates. That's sort of what hers do. It's not that defined, but so this first brow, it's going to be behind here and then kind of pulls in. I'm gonna finish that shape so you can see it. Let's do the same on the other side. She's got these cool bangs too in her hair, so we're actually not gonna see where the brows end up. That's gonna go behind the hair. So let's draw the hair. So the first line I actually want to draw, her part is a little off to the right side of our drawing. So I'm just going to draw kind of a rounded line from the right side of center over, just kind of overlaps the lashes and the eyebrow like that. There's always one little loose hair here, so I'm just going to start putting that in a little V like that. Her shapes are kind of complicated if you look at them all together, but when we break them down piece by piece, it feels like it's manageable. We're going to be coloring in a lot of hair soon, so get ready for that. So from here, the hair kind of drops down in front of that great cheek that we drew and kind of has an arced line back towards the middle. This is the kind of the hair that hangs down on the side of her head. Connects here. So eventually we're going to color all of this in with a darker color. I'm going to wait till then so we don't color it in twice. And I like doing these little wispy things at the end to show that the hair is kind of curling in. And let's go ahead and do the other side. So the other side has a similar thing, but we're going to put the hair actually behind the cheek just so that it's not the same on both sides. We can do a couple different things. So it's going to arc down to that cheek. And then I'm going to do the same kind of these lines, but behind the cheek. And this is going to be over here. Just coloring this in so we can see it, but we can color it in later with our darker color. Do those wispies. Cool, let's go ahead and build the top of the hair. Now, if we think about it, her hair from the side has a couple different layers, so I'm going to draw the hair from the side over here. I'm just going to draw it kind of like a cube. So if this is her face from the side, she's looking over here. Then the bangs come this way, and that's one piece. And then there's a second piece of all the hair that's pulling up into the ponytail back here. So that's piece number two, and then piece number three is the actual ponytail. So what we're going to draw now is this part here, where the front bangs, the highest part of them. So that is starting from this line, just going to go up and then arc around to the other side. Probably about this point that people are feeling like they want to throw their drawing away and quit drawing forever. Don't do it. You're doing fine, I promise. Gotta get to the end. Every day, somebody comes up and says that they wanted to give up, and then by the end of it, they were surprised at how accurate it was. So, be that person. Okay, so now we're gonna do this next part of the hair. We're not gonna see all of this stuff, but from the side, we might see a little bit bunching out over here, and then it wraps around the top. So it's gonna be a little bit more rounded than here, and it's gonna be higher on the top than it is on the sides. So what that means is we'll start behind the ear. I like going straight up from the side, and then like a big round line to the other side. So what I didn't draw here is she has a little tie made out of gummies that kind of pull her ponytail in together. So let's just draw a little bump. I'm gonna put the ponytail on this side on my paper because I have all this stuff over here. So I'm gonna put the bump right there. So this is part one of the gummy. Just put little lines in there, little rounded lines to show that it's curved. And then the two little strands are just kind of these wild, almost like Goofy's ears that stick off to the top. If you did the Goofy class a couple days ago, they're pink. And so I'm just getting ahead of it. And I have a pink that I'm coloring with. So that's what I'm using. Okay, let's do the ponytail. So the ponytail is going to be a fun shape. It's wild. It's going to go up and then around to the side. So a lot of times when you see artists draw, they might do the shape over the page before they commit to putting the pencil on the page. And that's just sort of, it's like these warm-ups, sort of to see the line before you make the line. So it would be up and then out like that. So it's like a backwards S shape. We see that a lot in our drawings, right? It's gonna have to connect back into her head here, so don't want to go too far out. Ponytail has a lot of personality. It's got a lot of bounce to it, and most of that bounce is handled by our technical animation team. The animators are able to animate it, but technical animators are the ones who simulate the hair, and they add a lot of character to this, so it's just as much a part of her as everything else. So I'm just going to arc back in here, keeping it rounded and light. So before we move on to the eyes, she has these little candy pieces in her hair, and those are fun to draw. They're just little ovals that you can put. I put mine on the left side of the bangs. Circles, different shapes. It's up to you what kind of candies you want to put there. And then some on the right side of this part over here. So that's the second layer. And then just anywhere up in the top of the ponytail. But those will be fun. When we color in the hair, we're going to skip these parts. These are candy. So now let's figure out where she's looking. This is the last step before we commit to the final lines. So her eyeballs, the irises, are circles. Let's give her little circles here so that she's really excited. And then we have some space between the iris and the top of the eye. We call that the whites above the eye when we're designing expressions. And that helps show fear if we have the eyebrows that are scared, or happiness, or for Vanellope, it's just going to look like intensity. So I'm just going to draw the full circle, even though we're going to see it below. Just want to figure out how big we want it to be. I'm going to go about that big. And then just darken in the parts that we want to keep. Same thing on the other side. So for the other side, when I do it, just to keep her from looking cross-eyed, or the opposite of cross-eyed is wall-eyed, where they look out to the far sides. I want to try to mimic the same amount of space here between the iris and the end of the eyeball. So that's about here. Yep, probably a little more. And then I want to do the pupil, which is just a smaller circle that's the same direction as the other one. And then within that, we're gonna do a little highlight circle. And that's an area we're not gonna color in. And that is our underdrawing for Vanellope. Before we move on, I thought it'd be fun to show you, I have this book that I had in the making of both Frozen and Wreck-It Ralph. And so I have all my notes in here. And like I said, I was a trainee, crowds animator for Wreck-It Ralph. And that meant for most of the film, I got to animate background characters. And I did get to do a few shots, but that help you, training you to slowly kind of roll into doing production shots. But at the end of the film, they allowed us to do these, what they call toolkits, which is animations of characters doing a fun thing and then leaving the screen. And then a lot of companies might use that for advertising, or it could be on billboards in Times Square. But I have my planning notes for Vanellope here. And so she was driving in, brushed her hair out of her eye, gave us a thumbs up, and then turned back and then drove away. So these are some sketches that I did as I was planning the animation. And it was fun to see that again. So if you're working on projects on your own, even in your own house, I suggest keeping a book because they're fun to stumble across. There's a lot of cool notes in here and caricatures of other animators that I was working with. Okay, time to use our black pencil. So I'm gonna sharpen it. And if you've seen this before, you know very well that I'm right-handed. So that means that I start on the left side of the drawing and then work across to the right. And that helps me not smudge the drawing as I go. If I ever need to kind of work on something and what might smudge it, I could just put a sheet of paper down between my hand and the drawing, and then that way I can move my hand around and not smudge anything. So I imagine I might need to do that with her hair. So let's get started. I'm going to start on the ear because that's the leftmost area. I'm going to finish this ear and make sure that you can see it and that it's not like shiny. Cool, that works. So all of this I'm going to color in. She has this jet black hair, so I'm going to use a lot of pencils today. Something like that. Okay, let's work out the cheek. Even as you're outlining and coloring in, it's okay to kind of color in through the hair, and like if the cheek is here, just to indicate that. I don't know if you can see it in the drawing, but these little lines help continue the flow. Even the eyebrows, if you want to continue them past, that's okay. So I like assuming that these candies are all circular. They're just kind of, if they're an oval, they're kind of turned. So what I'll do then is I'll just draw little curved lines within that, and that gives them some dimensionality, like a little donut, like a hair donut. You know what I mean. Okay, so this is where it gets weird, the overlap, because we have a lot of overlapping shapes. The hair is in front of all of it. Control. Okay, so I'm gonna do the eyebrows now. And again, I'm still continuing the lines back here. I don't have to fully define it, but I don't want to forget that it's back there. She's a fun character to draw. She has a lot of really great round shapes that are part of her personality. So it's always great when the character design reflects who the character is as a person. Ralph is rigid and squared off, and that's why he's rigid and squared off. Bill Schwab was the character designer for Wreck-It Ralph, the film, and also Frozen. A great artist has a ton of appeal in his work, so it's always fun getting to work with him. He also was the character artist for Moana. Brought up a funny point that we drew Grumpy on the day that rent was due. It's true. It's true. I didn't plan it, but it's true. Come back and do the eyes later. They always make me nervous, so I don't want to rush it. Color in last. If I color in now, I'm going to get smudged all over the place. Okay, so this is a situation where I'm probably going to put a sheet of paper down so that I can do the rest of the hair. This. I don't know if you got to see it yesterday. I did a fun video for the Disney Animation YouTube and Instagram and Twitter, all the different social media things, where I got to do a caricature of Walt Disney. That was fun. There is no how to draw Walt Disney out there, but I went through and kind of analyzed him in the same way that we look at our characters. Try to find the right way to draw him. If you haven't seen that yet, check it out. It's a fun video. Another candies. So if you have a color pencil set, these candies are fun to go back to. Okay, no more procrastinating. We gotta do the eyes. I'm gonna start with the left eye. Let me see the fourth one. We'll know it's there. Part. I need to find some calm music. This is stressing me out. So if you're working with color pencils, she has kind of dark brown irises, this part. So you can do that if you like. Now we're just coloring it in. So I'm gonna color in the eyebrows first. They're gonna be pretty dark. See how there's some asymmetry in the face where the hair is kind of covering up more of this eyebrow than that one? Asymmetry is, if you can ever get it in your drawing purposefully, then that's always something worth trying to find. Just so it isn't like too symmetrical. Sometimes it's easy to teach, like when we drew Mickey, he was symmetrical. But as you're designing your own characters, I'm gonna try to find ways to help the design be a little asymmetrical in places that make sense. So maybe it's the hair or eyebrows. So one thing I'm gonna do as I'm thinking about these three different parts of the hair, just so we don't lose the separation, I'm gonna make them progressively darker as they go back. So this front hair is gonna be the lightest part. And it's gonna get darker as we go back to the ponytail. Then we go a little darker. I'm sure this is fascinating. Watching paint dry, but it's a manual. But you know what? I appreciate you being here. Okay, that's the big one. You know what? Procrastinating. Maybe another way to do it, so that I don't break my hand, is I'm gonna just make it darker right at where it contacts. So right at the point where the hairs meet, it's gonna be darkest here around these lines. And then I might fade out to a lighter, be at least as light as the middle piece. Just because I don't know that my hand or you could take it, watching me color in. Thank you. the whole thing. I could speed this up for a time lapse, but if I have to endure it, you have to endure it. This isn't a cooking show. There's no finished drawing under my desk that I'm like, oh, well, look at that. 10 minutes later, we're all going through this together. Change to this. Okay, can't tell. Just turn my pencil sideways so that it covers a little bit more quickly. So might have to go over this a couple times to get the shading to be the right color, but she's a fun character to draw. Maybe you drew your ponytail smaller than me because you're smart. Wasn't gonna color in her eyes or the candies, but you know, after spending all this time, I feel like I've earned it. Little shadows for the candies, because why not? Perfectionist. We're gonna find some brown. Brown. This is a cool pencil. It's like the whole front of it is lead. I don't know what kind it is. It just says Resso. So I've sharpened away the name of this thing, but I think if you look up woodless pencils, they're basically these. So I'll color in a couple of the parts. Her skin is this really peachy, light pink, so I'm gonna see if white is fine by the time we've done everything. Ooh. Her nose, luckily, is pink, and I already have that, so I'm going to color in. And I'm actually going to shade in the bottom a little bit so it's darker. And then using the side of my pink pencil, I'm just going to give her a little bit of blush. She's got these bright red cheeks. I don't want to get too bright. Okay, now it's the part where the candies come in. So I'm going to color just randomly. Don't do the same colors as me. Pick different colors. Or pick different ones to be green. Let's go. Definitely red. Let's give it red. I'll make one of them a mint. Think about your favorite candies and put those in there. What other colors do I have? Got an orange. It's gonna be an orange candy right there. This is the orange we use for Olaf's nose. Yellow. Got all kinds of candy. I'm gonna do one blue candy. I like, we're doing two blue candies. And now that everything else is colored in, I'm gonna color this in a little bit darker. Whew, the song is appropriate, guys. We are going the distance on this drawing. Same peach that I used for Goofy. Let's see how that works. Can't even see. The pink. What does pink do? That's pretty good. I don't know when to quit. I will draw forever. What have I done? You guys, what have I done? You didn't sign up for this. You asked me to teach you how to draw, not color. Yeah. Dragging you through this. You know, I'm sorry. On behalf of myself and everyone who's watching, I'm sorry that we decided to do this. Coloring in. We're almost done, though. We're so close. This is appropriate sign how far I'll go, and I don't even know. Okay. And that is our fully colored in Vanellope. Why not just add a little shade? You know what? Look at this tongue. It's not even colored in. Red. If I go, there's no telling how far I'll go. Okay. Okay. Stop it. We're done. We're done. We did it. Alright, oh, we're not, you have to sign it, don't forget. I'm gonna sign my name right here. Drawing with Woodsy, great. Let's put this back here. To finish up.
Awesome, so hopefully you had a good time drawing and coloring in. She has a lot of space to color in, so hopefully that wasn't too much. I'm just fixing the focus here. Here we go. And don't forget, now that we're done, we have to wash up our hands. So I'm going to do that now because I have a lot of different colored pencils all over my hands. Thank you for joining me. I hope you had a good time drawing Vanellope. I've had fun with her ever since I met her in 2012. So don't forget to sign your drawing. Share it. You can hashtag it drawing with Woodsy. You can tag me in it if you put it in your Instagram stories. And if you do that, then I share it. So at the end of the day, all of the people who've drawn for that day, who shared their drawings, I posted up online. So that's always fun. Thank you for spending your afternoon with me. Just because we're separated doesn't mean we need to be alone. And I'm happy you're here. So thank you for being here, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.